Time to go back to the Middle Ages, and we will start off with Heroes and Castle 2. This game has a lot of myths, hack and slash with RPG elements along with troop management and family defense. All four different genres go well together in this game. You can engage in real-time battles while managing your army and defending the castle against enemies. There will be a lot of work to do besides defending. You must capture enemies' apples to get the technologies that can significantly boost your army, along with making your hero more powerful with a variety of equipment as well as upgrades and more, all of which adapt to the game. It might take a bit of time to get used to controlling your hero and your army at the same time, but the game is overall really well done.
Fire! He shall be redeemed. For the king!
Next up, we have World Legends. It's really cool to see a game made by a team who is passionate about Warcraft 3, and I, myself, am also a fan of it. Anyway, the gameplay is identical. You can command units in battle, construct buildings, get resources such as gold and wood, and also hire units as well as heroes. There are a variety of modes, including campaign and PvP. The controls are well designed to make us feel like we are playing PC version, and the tutorial levels are modern enough to help you understand the details of the game without getting annoyed. The game at the moment is still in beta, so there might be some bugs while playing, but overall, great game.
Be gone!
Yay!
Light guides me. I won't fall!
Next, we have Moonshades. This game is very loyal to old school dungeon crawler games in terms of controls. The movement is grid-based, where you can only move in four directions and turn left and right. You control two heroes at the same time, but they always go together, so the controls are still very simple. There are lots of enemies, along with plenty of loot that you can get. The game also had a variety of puzzles that require thinking, NPCs that you can talk, trade, and get quests. A great feature is that although two heroes start the same, you can make them unique with plenty of upgrade options. Overall, good game, good graphics, I would recommend. Another game that worth mentioning is One Epic Night. This game is old, like 10 years now, but it deserves more attention since there's only more than 500k downloads. Anyway, the gameplay is similar to other Endless Runner games, but with some unique mechanics. Not only you can dodge traps and enemies, you can also defeat enemies and destroy obstacles using sword and shield. The game looks great, along with good soundtrack and funny voice line. Not to mention the fact that there is no ads pop-up, so you can enjoy this game the fullest. Overall, this game is old, but gone.
Oh yeah, I meant to do that. I was just practicing my ragdoll.
Next game is also underrated, which is called Gotham Knights. The gameplay is exactly like the title suggests. You can attack, block, and every time you time the block button correctly, the knight can and will counter the enemy attack. The gameplay is straightforward, and the progress is satisfying with increasingly powerful enemies with unique attack patterns that require a lot of countering and also thinking. The art style is great, the story is basic but engaging, and the characters are very likable. If you want a game that can test your reflex, then this game is for you. Next, we have Occidental Heroes. It's an RPG game, but without any fantasy theme. There's no magic, no monster, or guns. The game set exactly in medieval era. In this game, you can create a group of 4 people, explore the Occident land with plenty of quests as well as enemies. But again, this is a fantasy team. Instead, we have a bunch of bandits who want to rob people, soldiers who quit the army, animals in real life such as wolves and more. The gameplay is simple but requires deep tactics in each battle. This game is also very challenging but with charm, permadeath, supplies needed while traveling, managing your character morale, etc. Overall, with just 35 megabytes, this game will not let you disappointed. If you want to earn real money while playing, then next up we have Knight of Katina. Knight of Katina is a PvP multiplayer game with a mix of chess and RPG. In this game, you must position your units and plan every move very carefully to win against players. There are 4 types of units, including knight, archer, mage, and priest, each with a unique attack pattern. Every battle you win or lose will give you gold that can be used to buy equipment. From there, you can equip your units to make them stronger and thus change the outcome of the battle. In addition, if you have any equipment that you don't like, you can sell it to other players. As I mentioned before, this game is play and earn, which means you can earn real profit while still enjoying the game. That's if you are interested, otherwise I would recommend this game.
Spirit, give me strength. I'll be praying to the light.
Hey? Give me something to crush. Hey? Give me something to crush.
Did someone call for a healer?
The game I'm going to mention next is Post Knight 2. Compared to other games in this list, this game is pretty chill. You play as a postman and your job is to deliver products while defeating monsters along the way, hence the name. In this game, you will be able to explore the world of Prism with a variety of locations as well as monsters. Each successful delivery will give you resources in order to buy equipment and items. Besides that, there are plenty of things to do as well. You can patrol the area, do some of work, and you can even have romance with several characters and collect memories with them. The story is chill, the graphics are cute, and the sound is soothing, all of which make this game very enjoyable. Coming up next is a game that has the most beautiful graphics in this list, which is 952. This is a fighting game that combines realistic combat mechanics and RPG elements. There are plenty of weapons and gears that you can get to customize your knight, and you can also enhance the equipment in order to be stronger. However, the game also relies on player's skills and tactics in each fight. You must learn how the enemies fight, dodge, block, and find the best time to attack the enemies. The graphics are beautiful, with very detailed models along with realistic animations. There are several modes to keep you engaged: story mode, PvP where you fight against other players, and events with unique stories as well as reward. Finally, we have Steel & Flesh 2. Steel & Flesh 2 doesn't have any single fantasy elements, and instead, it is very aggressive, if not the most, to actual middle-aged events. You can explore a huge world with over 20 states, be an ally or enemy with other states, and capture territories. When engaging the battle, you can let the battle go automatically, or you can take part in battle with your army in many locations, including open field, fort, city, village, and castle. In addition, you can also start a business along with sending or recruiting the units to battle or to defend the states. The graphics might not be the best considering the small size, and it might be confusing to understand the game at first since there's no tutorial, but the game is still worth recommending for those who haven't played yet.